Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_008_DIAB where you saved it. Or you can download this file from the website, or you can just sit down and watch. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_009_DIAB and click the save button. Before we proceed, let's create some layers. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer properties. This will bring the layer properties manager. Now click the new button and create a new layer. Name this layer 2D Furniture. And change its color to, you can give it whatever color you want to give it. I'm going to give mine the index color 23. Okay. Click the new button again and rename this layer to 2D plants. Change its color to the index color. I'm going to give my 96. You can give whatever color you want to give yours. Close the layer properties manager. Now, before you go into the design center, make sure that the you change the current layer, because when you drag object from the design center, the object take on the properties of the current layer. Click this down arrow and select the furniture layer. Now hold down your shift key and type number 2 on your keyboard to bring the design center. You see these blocks because I used the design center previously. But if you open the design center for the very first time, your display will be different than mine. In any situation, I'm going to click the home button. This will return me to a state as if I opened the design center for the very first time. Now look at this folder, the third one, which en-us, and double click it. Double click the design center and double click home space planner. Double click block. This will bring the different blocks you need for to complete your drawing. Now click the table and drag it into the drawing. Because the furniture layer is the current layer, the table automatically takes on the current layer. Again, this is depend to the time when the block was created. We're going to learn more about block when we get a tutorial specifically for the blocks. Select the sofa and drag it into the drawing. You can select as many objects as you can from the design center. If you find that you don't need object later, but you can delete it from the drawing. Now select the bed and move it into this room. Select the chair and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Move this chair into this area. You can arrange all the blocks later. Now just move them into the area approximately where they're supposed to be. Select the dining table and move it approximately into the dining, or hold down your shift key and move it here. select this lamp and use the move tool to move it into this area. Select this chair and move it into the guest room. Select the plant and move the plant into the living room. Hold down your control key and type number 2 again to bring the design center. Click the back arrow button to go back. Click it once more and double click the kitchen. Double click blocks. Now you can look for different items which you want to use for your kitchen. Let me select this faucet, kit, top, sink top. Then select this block. Select this single zinc. Select this. Close the design center. As you can see, all these blocks take on the current layer, but these are in the wrong layer. So select all of these objects and move them into the kitchen layer. Press escape. Now select this and use the move tool to move it into this area. Turn off the proper mode if it's on and place it here. You can rotate it after us. Now select all of them and move them approximately into the kitchen area. Now select this block, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the rotate command. At the specifying base point prompt, click anywhere in the block and type 90 for 90 degree rotation. Now try to move this block in the right place. Now select this block, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the prompt specifying base point or displacement prompt, use the midpoint object snap and snap at the midpoint of this block. At the specifying second point or use the first point as displacement, use the midpoint of this line, this green line, and place the block. Now the block fits nicely into there. Select this block and delete it. Select the zinc and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the specifying base point prompt, use this as the base point. At the specifying second point or use the first point at this point, click here. Select this block and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the rotate command. Use this as the base point and rotate the block. Now select the block and use the move command. Move this block at the top. Now select this block again and use the move command. At the prompt specifying base point prompt, click at this midpoint, then move this into this area. Now try to arrange all this block into the drawing area so that you can switch your purpose. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the select object prompt, select this block, press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, click here as the base point. As a specifying second point or use the first point as a displacement, hover your mouse cursor into this area and slowly move back. When you see, go to the status bar and turn on the perpendicular objects now. Now try to snap into this area and place the block. Again, select this block and go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the prompt specifying base point prompt, use the midpoint of this block as the base point. As the prompt specifies second point or use the first point as a displacement, move your mouse cursor and hover the mouse cursor at this point, then move it and hover it here. Now move slowly and hold down the shift key to turn off the auto mode and snap into this area. Select this block and use the move tool. Use the midpoint object snap to snap at a specifying as a specify this point, or click move this into this area and place it here. Now select the block again and use the move command. Click and move it slightly down. Select this block and use the copy command. Click the midpoint of this block and paste it to the midpoint of this block. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the block again. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rotate command. At the prompt, specify base point. Use the midpoint of this block and move your mouse cursor into this direction. When your block runs like mine, click. Again, the auto mode needs to be on. Now, we need to move this block. So select this block and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the prompt, specifying base point, displacement prompt. Use the midpoint of this block as the base point. At the prompt, specify second point or use the first point as a displacement. Move your mouse cursor and hover the mouse into the midpoint of this object and the midpoint of this object. Now move the mouse slowly. When the temporal line intersects, click. Select the block and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the prompt, specify first point of mirror line. Use the midpoint of object now to snap at the midpoint of this block. Then move either to the left or to the right and click. Press enter to accept the default option. Select the dining table and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rotate command. At the prompt, specify base point prompt. Click approximately to the center of the dining table. Now enter 90 degrees and press enter. Select the table and go to the home tab, modify panel, and use the move command. Click into this area and move down a little bit. Select the door and delete it. Now go to the home tab, select this chair, and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Select the chair and move it up. Press enter to repeat the move command again. Select this chair and move it slightly to the right. Select the chair, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the specifying base point of mirror line, hover your mouse cursor here and move slightly. Type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Now turn off your auto mode or turn on your polar tracking and snap this to 45 degree or 225 degree. Click. Press enter to accept the no default option. Now select this table and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Try to add the prompt, specify base point. Click approximately at the center of this table and move it between the two chairs that you just placed. Select this chair and click delete on your keyboard. Now select the plant and use the move tool to move it slightly into the right corner. Select this lamp and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move tool. Click and move this lamp into this corner. Now select the chair and move the plant and move it into the plant layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this bed. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. Use the midpoint object snap and click. Now move into the opposite direction and click. Type yes to delete the source object. Select the bed and use the move command. Click this bed and move it down a little bit. Select this chair and delete it. Go to the home tab. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, in this tutorial, it learned all the different techniques, how to bring block from the design center to your project. In the next tutorial, we'll copy this plan and start to develop the first block plan. If you find this tutorial useful, share it to your friend. If you have any comment or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial in my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next tutorial. Goodbye.